What's going on, lads and lasses? Welcome back to 100% Mags. So there's quite a bit of Newcastle United news to get through today. Of course, Newcastle have released the prices for the match pass for all of our pre-season games. I will be talking about that in the video today. Also, Newcastle as well have had another departure from the club. Ben Dawson, of course, the academy manager, has departed from the club. He's done quite a bit with Newcastle over the years, and he has now departed from the club. Of course, I will be talking about his departure from the club in the video as well. Also, some pictures of the Newcastle United stacks at St James's Park, of course, and how that has progressed as well. So, without further ado, let's get straight into it. So, first off, let's talk about, of course, the departure of Ben Dawson. Now, Ben Dawson, of course, has vacated his position to pursue a first-team coaching opportunity at Leicester City. Newcastle, of course, have put out their thanks to Ben for his excellent contribution to Newcastle United and wish him well for the future. Obviously, Ben Dawson came to the public eye through his work with the Youth Academy. Newcastle United, he was doing some fantastic stuff with the youth lads not that long ago, and now he has been given an opportunity by Leicester City to take a first team coaching job at Leicester. So he's took that chance and now he is off to Leicester City. And on behalf of everybody that watches this channel, you know, I wish Ben Dawson all the best, because the lad has been absolutely fantastic. You know, he's done some brilliant stuff with the Youth Academy in the time that he has been here. So I wish him all the best at Leicester City. I hope he, you know, flourishes there. I hope he gets to, you know, do what he wants to do at Leicester as well. But he will go, you know, with all respect, because he has been an absolutely fantastic servant for this club. That could possibly mean that we may be going down that avenue of what we were talking about on the channel not that long ago, with Neil Bath and of course the other guy from Leicester, from Chelsea, coming in. Maybe that could be why Ben Dawson may be departing. I'm only speculating here, so don't take it for granted. Don't take it as gospel. I am only speculating on this, of course. But that may mean that Neil Bath could be coming in with his friend from Chelsea. And if they are, then whoa, we are going to have an absolutely fantastic youth setup if we do have them coming in. But only time will tell on that one. Like I say, it's not actually out there. It's not being said by anybody else. I'm just throwing it out there myself is a possibility, you know, with Ben Dawson leaving, that that could be what could be about to happen. You know, like I say, it's not gospel, so don't take it for, you know, any credible news. It's just my opinion on that, of course. Moving on to talk about the tickets. Now, I can see there's going to be quite a few people probably complain about this. When I first seen it, I wasn't the greatest opinion on it, to be honest. I didn't have the best opinion on it. Looking at the price, it does look pretty bad. But at the end of the day, we are getting six games. The money is going to go back into the club, as my brother said as well. You know, he said that he's all for it because the money goes back into the club. If that had been the previous regime, you know, then he wouldn't have been doing it. He wouldn't have been buying it. But knowing that the money goes back into the club, you know, there's a lot of people that I'm sure might go down this route and pay the £24.95 as a non-member. If you are a member, of course, of the Magpie Plus, then you only need to pay £8.99 to get all six games. If you're a member of the Mags membership, then it's £14.99, and if you're a junior Mags member, then it's £14.99 as well. Non-members, which of course is myself, my family, we are non-members. We don't have a membership, unfortunately, because is, quite expensive to have a membership. But it's $24.95 for non-members, so when you look at it, you're getting six games. You're getting Hull City. You're getting the two Japanese games, of course, for the Japan tour. You're getting the Salah weekend games as well against Girona, AC Milan, and the other team as well. So it's worth it when you look at it from that aspect. But I can see there's going to be quite a few people. Like I say myself, I looked at the price and I thought, whoa, that's quite a big step up, to be honest, from what people were getting charged for the Australian one. But you've got to remember the Australian one was only two games. This is six games. And like I say, at the end of the day, if the money goes back into the club, then, then it's worth it, to be honest. I can see the positives to the price, because this money could go back, well, it will go back in, and it will help us to be able to go out there and buy some more players for the first team, buy some more players for the women's team as well. So it's going to be beneficial moving forward. Like I say, there will be people obviously that'll complain about the price. It is quite a step up, but like I say, there's many silver linings to it, that the money will go back into the club. The money will help us, get past that PSR problem as well that crept up in this transfer window. But moving on away from that, let's look at, of course, a little bit news about Kieran Trippier. Once again, another update on Kieran Trippier. According to Nicolò Chiesa, I believe they're pronounced. Sorry if I've butchered the name there. But they are saying that Kieran Trippier has received a rich bid from a Saudi club. Now, this person has 327,000, I believe it is, followers on Twitter. So maybe you could believe this, but like I always say, take it with a pinch of salt, and let's wait until, there is concrete information from some more credible sources out there, the likes of Romano, Ornstein. Once you see Ornstein or Romano talking about it, then you can, start to believe it a little bit more, because they do have a little bit more of a clout in the world of, journalism for football. They do have a bit more of a clout, and they do have their finger on the pulse. So on this one, I'd maybe wait and see what happens with that, because I'm not too sure on that one. But the person, like I say, does have 327,000 followers, so maybe they could be a credible journalist, but we'll have to wait and see on that one. There's also been reports from Martin Hardy as well, coming out saying that Newcastle have moved on a bid for Milik Fo. Open a move to England. Of course, he is with Newcastle. You got to push through a move. Newcastle's initial evaluation is thought to be around the 25 million mark. AC Milan are looking for a fee around 35 million. So maybe we can come to an agreement there somewhere, around the 30 million mark, maybe for Malik Four. And Newcastle have been in contact with AC Milan, of course. All this coming from Martin Hardy. And then let's get straight to the last topic of this video. Of course, you will see it now. Pictures up on screen of course, the St. James's Stacks powered by Salah. This has been going on for months on end now. It was hoped that it would be ready for the Euros. Unfortunately, it got delayed. It got kicked back on that, and it looks like it is going to start to be ready by the looks of it, and by the looks of the image, as it looks like it will be ready in time for the new season kicking off. So it's starting to look really, really nice, as you can see from the pictures. They've got the sign up now, they've got a lot of different stuff up. Obviously, there's still a few areas that you can see where they still need to do some work, but it's starting to look like what the concepts were showing. Maybe even better than what the concepts were showing as well, in my opinion, because it does look really, really nice. A lot of people talking about it, of course, online, and I can't wait to see when it finally opens. Of course, this is going to be a regular thing as well. It's not going to just be for match days, as I have said in previous videos talking about the stack at St James's. Of course, it's going to be a throughout the week, every single day, it is going to be operating, so it's going to generate a lot of money for the area. It's going to generate a lot of money for Newcastle as well, so it's going to be a really good chance, to get that PSR problem solved and get that money coming in, get that money flowing into the club. But anyway, let us know your thoughts down in the comments below. As always, remember to like, share, subscribe to the channel. I'm on the road to 2.5k subscribers. It's taken a little while to get there. We are at about 2076, I think it is at the minute, so we are a reasonable way off that 2.5k. But hopefully, with the support from you guys and lasses, I will get there in the end. I have also just launched a brand new website. You can go check it out at 100pctmags.co.uk. That's where you can go and buy merchandise for the channel. At the moment, of course, there is the Eddie Howe print up on there, and there is a digital download where you can download a Bruno Guimaraes wallpaper for either your iPhone or Android phone, and there is also a one where you can buy it and it is for your tablet, PC, Mac, what have you, for to go onto them as well. So that is where you can go check that out. It's at 100pctmags.co.uk. That is the website, and that is where I will be, of course, putting merchandise up for people to go and buy. Like I say, there's some digital ones up there at the minute of Bruno, and there's the Eddie print as well. I will be hopefully trying to get a few more prints done, but of course I am designing them myself, so it will take a little while to do them, around, of course, doing the content on the channel. And if you want any more digital wallpapers added up as well, then let us know, of course, and I will get around to them. Let us know what you want as well for prints, and I'll see what I can do on that as well. Who would you like prints made out of as well? At the moment, like I say, I've got the Eddie one. I've got Bruno one up there as well, on the Ko-fi store. I will be putting that, of course, onto the actual website as well. You can still go buy from the Ko-fi store as well if you want to. But I will, of course, be posting on both of them, the items, so you can buy from whichever one you want to buy from. But till next time, I'll see you all for the next one, and enjoy the lads.